The Emergency Operations Collection Management Tool was designed to assist the emergency response community with obtaining timely, accurate, and relevant geospatial imagery, products, and services before, during, and after a disaster. The Collection Management Tool links to the Hazards Data Distribution System, allowing users to preview existing data for active emergency operations events, allows users to view public requests for additional data acquisitions, and provides an interface to submit new data acquisition requests. The data acquisition requests facilitate the collection of remotely sensed data in the aftermath of a disaster, as well as coordinating imagery of the same region prior to an event. Let's discuss the different areas on the homepage. The Events menu is located on the left side of the interface, and the Map interface and Map tools are located on the right. Use the following controls to navigate the Google Map. Click and drag the Street View icon to navigate to the street level view of the interested area. Click the plus sign to zoom into the center of the map. Click the minus sign to zoom out. You can also use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Click and drag the map to the desired location or view to pan and zoom the map. You can add your own web service layers in WMS format by opening the Map Layers tab. Other layers important to the emergency management community, such as NASA's Socioeconomic Data and Application Center, will be available here also. The information in this video is also covered in the help document. The Events menu provides access to information related to events so all interested users will be aware of the image collection plans, status, and availability of data during the course of an event response. Event status and details for historical events can also be accessed through this menu. The three main menu items are active events, archived events, and event search. The active events menu lists current emergency operations events. Clicking on the information icon next to the event provides additional information such as event type, status, start date, access to public data acquisition requests, and a coverage map for the area of interest. Data acquisition requests provide information on collection plans for specific image types. They can be viewed to assist with communication, management, and scheduling of the data acquisitions. A coverage map indicating the area of interest can also be viewed in this section. The date the data acquisition request was submitted, the acquisition start and end dates, the type of imagery needed, and the resolution are listed. The magnifying glass next to HDDS coverage provides a link to the HDDS Explorer and will open to the result page to view data that is currently available for the event, including pre-event data if it has been requested. This allows responders to view data that has already been acquired and organized for the natural or man-made disaster. Clicking on the thumbnail of the images for existing data will provide a larger image as well as the metadata for the image. For further information on using HDDS tools and other options available through the HDDS and Earth Explorer, which is the platform for the HDDS application, please review Lesson 7 videos. Lesson 7C is a detailed video on using search results. Next is the Archived Events menu, which provides access to historical events. Collection Management Tool events that have been closed are moved to this section. The information for this event will list the status as archived, and the event date will be displayed. The final item on this menu is the event search. This section allows users to search the inventory of active and archived events. Search criteria includes date range, geographic location, or type of event. A search by temporal extent can be executed by typing in the date range or by selecting a date using the pop-down calendar. After applying the filter, you expand the Active Events or Archive Events menu to view search results. The Spatial Extent search utilizes the Google Map interface to specify a location. There are six options using the geometry type. Note that if you have failed to log in, there will only be four options available. KML and shapefile upload options will be missing. To define a geographic location using a single point, select the point icon from the geometry type toolbar. Click an area on the map once using the mouse to define a single point search, or the latitude and longitude can be entered manually. Enter coordinates in decimal degrees, then click on Set Point. To define a geographic location by creating a bounding box, select the bounding box from the Geometry Type toolbar. Two points are used to define a bounding box: the latitude and longitude for the upper left corner and the lower right corner can also be entered manually. To define a geographic location by creating a polygon, select Multi-Point Polygon from the Geometry Type toolbar. Click multiple times on the map to define the area of interest. Up to 50 points can be used to create the polygon. Double-click to close the polygon. Latitude and longitude can also be entered manually one point at a time. To define a geographic location using a predefined boundary, select Predefined Area from the Geometry Type toolbar. A menu of states, counties, and congressional districts are available for the United States. Convenient pop-downs list all available options. To define a geographic location using a KML file, select KML Upload from the Geometry Type toolbar. Enter a spatial name for the area of interest. Use the Browse button to upload a Google Earth keyhole markup language file. The uploaded KML file can be accessed through the setting link on the top toolbar using the spatial name if additional data types are requested. To define a geographic location using a shapefile, select Shapefile Upload from the Geometry Type toolbar. Enter a spatial name for the area of interest. Use the Browse button to upload the shapefile components. The Esri shapefile dialog box requires SHP, SHX, DBF, and PRG files for the upload. The uploaded shapefile can be accessed through the setting link on the top toolbar using the spatial name if additional data types are requested. If you need to create a KML file or a shapefile, Video Lesson 11C provides quick methods for creating these files. The trash icon can be used at any time to clear the map. Finally, searches can also be done by selecting a natural or man-made disaster from the event type menu, with or without a temporal extent.